San Juan City Mayor Francis Zamora denies involvement in alleged corruption involving a government aid program. Senator J.V. Ejercito presented videos on Tuesday showing some San Juan City officials allegedly taking kickbacks from the Labor Department's Tupad program. Ejercito claims Zamora also has his share in the cash aid supposedly given to residents. But Zamora firmly denies the accusations.
Sino ho ba yung mga nasa video? Diba? Why don't they come forward? Ba't hindi ho sila pumunta rito para kung talaga bang merong nangyaring bigay ng pera o kickback? Ang dali-dali magsabi ng ganung paratang. Ano ho bang ebidensya meron sila upang patunayan na talagang ang tumanggap si Mayor ng 6-5?
Ejercito and Zamora are from rival political clans in Metro Manila's smallest city. The two were also engaged in a word war last year over plans to relocate monuments of national heroes in San Juan. Former President Rodrigo Duterte flip-flops on the controversial statements he made during a prayer rally in Davao last month. The former Philippine leader now denying ever calling his successor, President Ferdinand Marcos Jr., a drug addict. Ernel Tokmo with the full story.
Former President Rodrigo Duterte takes back his previous pronouncements on various issues. Last January, Mr. Duterte accused President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. of using illegal drugs. He even claimed to have seen a supposed drug list with Marcos's name on it.
Bongbong Marcos bangag noon, ngayong presidente na bangag natin ang presidente. Nung ako'y mayor, pinakitaan ako ng evidence ng PDEA. Doon sa listahan, nandoon yung pangalan mo. May drug addict tayo na presidente.
But when asked about it on Tuesday, Duterte is now singing a different tune.
Si presidente, wala akong sinabi na ganun. Mama, even if you kill me 1,000 times, wala akong sinabi na ganun. Taking a drug. Pero kung sabihin mo, adik, wala akong sinabi na ganun. Patayin ako ni Marcos niyan. Mahawa ka naman sa akin. Matanda na ako.
Duterte clarified he was referring to medicines such as antibiotics when he talked about the president's drug use. The Philippine Drug Enforcement Agency and the Philippine National Police have previously denied Marcos Jr. was never in their drug list. In a prayer rally in Davao last January, the former president strongly opposed the push for charter change, especially through a people's initiative. Duterte insists there's nothing wrong with the Constitution.
You want to perpetuate yourself in power at the expense ng buhay ng bayan. Bakit pumasok sa utak ninyo yung People's Initiative? Anong nakain ninyo? There's nothing wrong with the Constitution right now. The environment in the Philippines seems to be positive, okay. Wala namang problema.
But on Tuesday, the former president is now open to charter amendments, as long as it only touches economic provisions.
There is any provision at all, if at all, that would need a change or correction somewhere in the charter. Let us all cooperate. As long as we stick to the economic provisions. So you can begin by the legislation, then could lead up to the opening of the charter for changes and amendments. But it should be progressive.
He says possible term extensions should be off limits, including any provisions that could benefit the personal interests of lawmakers. Any changes, Duterte insists, should not favor incumbent official.
It must be purely motivated to improve the interest of government and country. It will never be used to promote the ambition or ambitions of Congress or by anybody else, even by the Supreme Court.
House lawmakers insist political amendments are off the table. They also welcome the vocal support coming from Marcos and former President Duterte.
Big cue for us na nagsama na ang dalawang influential persons ng Pilipinas ngayon, ang ating sitting president, PBBM, and former president saying cha-cha is good.
Kayong taga-Luzon, pumunta na yan kayo sa Mindanao, mag-declare na lang tayo ng independence separate. Bakit binababoy ninyo ang bayan natin?
Duterte also revisited his previous call for an independent Mindanao. But at this time, he appears to have abandoned this idea.
It has always the dream of some people to be independent. Pero if it causes a rupture in our entire system sa Republika, I will not go for it. I will not go for a forced carving out Mindanao out of the Philippines.
Hernel Tokmo, ABS-CBN News.
Former President Duterte also denying receiving bags of guns from controversial religious leader Apollo Quiboloy. Duterte was responding to an allegation thrown by a former Kingdom of Jesus Christ member who claimed during a Senate hearing he saw the Duterte's visit Quiboloy's property carrying a bag of firearms as they left.
Kami magtanggap ng baril kay Pastor Quiboloy. Ako pa ba ang delivery sa kanya ng tanyong bukas? It's a very stupid proposition. It's silly.
Or he had to go with military because it was an alamona. Mayor na ang bukid. Hindi mo alam ang kusin yung kalaban mo.
Duterte also has this piece of advice for his close friend and ally.
Get yourself arrested. This is a free country. If you do not want to go there, get arrested. I could not really say that I can validate the statement independently in Salita here. But what I can say is that maybe somehow his life is in danger. Alam mo ang kaso niya sa Amerika eh. Hindi naman dito. Malit na kaso yan. Amerika would not do it. But Amerika would not waste its time violating the law.
Quiboloy is included in the FBI's most wanted list. He is facing multiple charges in the U.S., including child sex trafficking and cash smuggling. Expelled Philippine lawmaker Arnolfo Teves Jr., now included in the International Criminal Police Organization, or Interpol's Red Notice List. A Red Notice is a request to international law enforcement to locate and arrest a person pending extradition or surrender. Teves was last seen in Timor-Leste. He is the alleged mastermind behind the killing of Negros Oriental Governor Roel Degamo and several others last year.
Ang red notice, yan ang pinakamalapit o similar to or akin to an international warrant of arrest. Kasi tayo sa political jurisdiction, sa political and criminal jurisdiction ng ating bansa, we can issue a warrant of arrest within our boundaries. Pag tumakas ang isang tao at nag-ibang bayan, humingi tayo ng tulong sa mga iba't ibang bansa. Tayo naman ay nakikisama rin na tumutulog din sa kanila na hulihin yung mga tinutugis ng batas upang sila ay mapanagot sa kanilang mga krimen.
Meanwhile, Justice Secretary Jesus Crispin Remulla says the DOJ is coordinating with the Solicitor General to possibly appeal the court decision of the killing of 17-year-old Jemboy Baltazar. The policemen accused of murdering Baltazar were convicted on lesser crimes by a Navotas court.
Gagawin natin ang lahat upang mabaliktad natin ang resulta. At pag-aaralan natin to kung kinakailangang dumulog tayo sa Korte Suprema tungkol sa mga lumabas at kung sino ang dapat managot, pupunta tayo sa Korte Suprema.
Turning now to maritime tensions between the Philippines and China. Beijing says it will continue to take necessary actions to protect its sovereignty and maritime interests in the South China Sea. The Philippine Navy earlier reported the presence of dozens of Chinese vessels and fishing boats in the West Philippine Sea.
First, China's position in the South China Sea issue is consistent and clear. China is seriously concerned about the Philippines' recent infringements in the South China Sea. China will continue to take necessary actions to resolutely safeguard our territorial sovereignty and maritime rights and interests and safeguard peace and stability in the South China Sea.
Beijing was responding to President Ferdinand Marcos Jr.'s statement, saying the presence of China's navy in the West Philippine Sea is worrisome. Marcos also vowed to protect Filipino fishermen in the area.
Maliwanag naman para sa atin, we don't really, we just watch, of course, what everybody is doing. But really, for us, patuloy pa rin natin. We just defend our maritime territory. We continue to support all of our fishermen, our fisher folk who are who make their living from these fishing grounds. At patuloy naman natin tutulungan sila. At despite whatever else happens, kung binablock tayo, kung ano, tinashadow, patuloy pa rin ang ating gagawin. Dahil yan naman ang trabaho natin. Trabaho natin, itulungan natin yung mga fishers na matagal na, ilang henerasyon na, doon nangingisda. That's the basic principle there, is that the fishers must be allowed to fish in their traditional fishing grounds which belong in the maritime territory of the Philippines.
Let's get an update now on the weather from PAGASA forecaster Anna Clauren. Good morning, Anna.
Good morning, Bettina. Currently, the northeast monsoon is still prevailing over the whole Luzon, and this will bring cloudy skies with light rains over Aurora. While Metro Manila and the rest of Luzon were expecting a generally fair weather condition, aside from isolated light rains also due to the Amihan or the northeast monsoon. While Davao region, we're still expecting a cloudy sky with scattered rain showers and thunderstorms due to the trough of a low-pressure area, while the rest of the country, we're expecting a partly cloudy to cloudy skies aside from isolated rain showers or thunderstorms, mostly in the afternoon or in the evening due to the easterlies or localized thunderstorm. Currently, we're not monitoring any weather disturbance that may affect the country for the next 3 to 5 days. And that's the latest from PAGASA. This is Anna Clauren. Good morning.
Thank you very much for that update, Anna.